Hallelujah. I will be reading for your hearing Psalms. There we go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will be reading for your hearing Psalms 136. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the God of gods, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his mercy endureth forever. To him alone doeth great wonders, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that by wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that stretched out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that made great lights, for his mercy endureth forever. The sun to rule by day, for his mercy endureth forever. The moon and the stars to rule by night, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that smote Egypt in their firstborn, for his mercy endureth forever, and brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endureth forever. With a strong hand and with a stretched out arm, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which divided the Red Sea into parts, for his mercy endureth forever, and made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endureth forever, but overthrew Pharaoh and his host in the Red Sea, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which smote great kings, for his mercy endureth forever, and slew famous kings, for his mercy endureth forever. Sion, king of the Amorites, for his mercy endureth forever, and Og, the king of Bashan, for his mercy endureth forever, and gave their land for a heritage, for his mercy endureth forever, even an heritage unto Israel his servant, for his mercy endureth forever, who remembered us in our low estate, for his mercy endureth forever, and hath redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endureth forever, who giveth food to all flesh, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord of heaven, for his mercy endureth forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Let the church say amen. Amen. Say amen again. Amen. I'm so glad to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. One more time. One more time. I said one more time. Somebody somewhere is crying over a dead relative. Somebody somewhere this morning buried somebody. Some people right now are sitting around eating a meal at a place they call a repast. But look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It could have been another way. Oh, you better believe it. It could have been another way. But to God be the glory. To God be the glory for all the things he has done. We thank you so much for your patience with us today and for everybody who is here one by one and name by name. To our general overseer, Bishop Sean Alton, would you please stand? And his lovely wife, elect Lady Evangelist Jerina Alton. To Assistant Pastor Alvin Tucker and his wife in the back. Bishop and Pastor Collins and over here to our Senior Bishop Alonzo Alton, Elder John Peterson, to all the musicians who are serving with us today, to Lady Rhonda Martino, the jewel of this house. We praise God for her. And look to your neighbor and say to you, come on, look at them and say, that means you, everybody. You, and you. It could have been another way. I received a text last night of a pastor friend of mine over in, I want to say he's in Camden or Delaware, who passed away. There's another pastor who they funeralized this morning. And someone told me, said, you wouldn't have believed all them people that was there. And I thought about the last time I went to an appreciation service for him. And you can throw a bat and find a seat, not hit nobody. But they said today it was people everywhere. So we're so glad for all of you that are here with us today for a happy occasion. And we are not going to deliberately prolong the time. As you see, I believe it's there. They put it on the little thing that you have, for you that have it, that the program is subject to modification. And I'm letting you know right now, we're going to take that liberty today. And we're going to change some things around and do as the Lord would lead us. Amen. We want everyone from the Frame family. Would you please stand? All from the Frame family, all of the siblings of Brother Richard. We'll do it that way. All right? Thank God. All of the siblings. If you're married to a sibling, would you stand? If you're met, there we go. So glad for all of you. And to everyone that is here today to support Sister Jennifer, the Rivera family, would you please stand? All of her family and friends. God bless you all. All co-workers, some that have traveled miles to be here. And we thank God for every last one of you. And to all of the Pentecostal Assembly of Jesus Only, all of the members there, and to our family and everybody else. Did that include everybody? Amen. Amen. Brother Duke Tola and the young man that is working with him today to record this. Praise the Lord. We thank God for him. And to all of the other ministers that we did not call your name, would you stand? All ministers, missionaries, evangelists, we did not call your name. Please stand. Y'all taking too long. Please stand. Thank you so much. God bless you. Amen. Thank you so much for being here. And to my little granddaughters, they're here today. I see two of them. God bless you. Amen. Sanaya and Siani. And I see some other surprises here. God bless you. At this time, we're going to have a selection from the Pentecostal Assembly of Jesus Only Mass Choir. God bless you as you come. Sing whatever you want to sing. Thank you. in all the earth. Your name is excellent. Let's give the choir a hand. I love family. How about you? You know, you have some people that hate their family. They don't get along with their family. But I want you to know something. You can make it work if you want to.
That's right.
And sometimes making it work means staying away from them and loving them from a distance. But you still got to love them. Amen. And what I want to do is I don't ever. My grandson, Jaden, said to me one day, some time ago, he went to school. And they had some type of, what were they doing, dress up or do some type of dressing, whatever. They always doing some type of something different. And he said, the lady told my friend that he looked nice, but she didn't say it to me. Isn't that something? That's how the minds of children work. So we want to make sure we do our very best not to offend nobody. And we want Jaden and what's your name? Yeah, what's your name? Stand up. Jaden and what's her name? Y'all think I'm joking. I done forgot. Suhaila. Stan, she was looking at me like, you acting like you don't know my name. I really did forget. We go through that nowadays. Praise the Lord. Let's give them a hand. And we would like to acknowledge the Dixon family. Would everybody in the Dixon family stand? All of the Dixons. There's some over there too. God bless you. Amen. Don't charge it to my head or my heart. Just know I forgot, okay? All right. At this time, we would like to take a moment of silence in memory of those that we love so much who are not here today. And that we know without a shadow of a doubt, if they were living here on the earth, they would be here. Amen. And as we were preparing for this, certain people were having moments, and it just be that way sometime, all right? So as we have our moment of silence in memory of, I'm not used to this here. What's this you wrote here, up here? Never mind, I got it now. All right, Robert and Sarah Dixon, the grandparents of Richard and his wife and family, parents of Lady Rhonda, Sister Renee Dixon, and Sister Davetta Dixon. The mother of Sister Jennifer Frain, Crucita Rivera, and the grandparents of Deacon Designate Richard Robert John Frain, Mr. John and Anna Frain. Moment of silence, please. Praise God for them in their life, and we thank God for this opportunity. Mm-hmm. What is it? All right, you say those names. You say that.
Praise the Lord, everybody. He tells me to remind them, then he tells me to say it. We also are grateful for our cousin Khadijah Wexler. Amen. And her friend and the Ridley School District, Sister Renee Dixon's friends. Oh, your co-workers are here? Okay. Oh, they left. Oh, okay, and Brother Richard's co-workers.
Y'all pray for us, because you know, we're not getting mad. This is the first time we've been in here all year long.
Amen.
And I tell you, that Zoom spoils you. kind of forget. Hey, I'm about to retire anyway, so it'll be all right. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. We thank God for all of you. At this time, we're going to prepare ourselves to go further in this service, and we ask that you will try, if you have to use the bathroom, if you would please try to go now. There's one out there, and there are two back there. So if you have to go, please try to go now or after the reading, and then we're going to try to move forward in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This sixth day of May 2023, the day which the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. First, on behalf of our servant leaders and ministers, J.D. and Lady Rhonda Martineau I, Liberty Temple, and the Dixon Frame and Rivera families, we welcome one and all. Today, on this blessed and holy seventh day, the Sabbath day of the Lord, we've gathered for the purpose of uniting to officially present to Yahweh, our Almighty God, a little prince in Israel, Richard Robert John Frame II, a fourth generation child born unto Richard and Jennifer Frame into the Dixon, Frame, and Rivera families. Richard Robert John Frame, a Hebrew name meaning strong, hard ruler. Robert, of Spanish origin, is said to mean bright fame. John, also a Hebrew name, which means Yahweh has been gracious, and used in the New Testament of the Bible. With such a well-researched name to be given to him, and with great excitement and anticipation, Yahweh bless the earth realm and our lives on the Sabbath, February 18th, in the year of our Lord, 2023, 27 Shavuot 5783 at 9:14 a.m. in the post meridian. Richard Robert John Frame II, whose primary nickname is Rush, delivered at a healthy birth weight of 7 pounds, 9 ounces, and 19 inches at Riddle Hospital in Media, PA. As we all welcome him at 2.5 months old, let us unite in praises to Almighty God for this precious gift he has blessed all of our lives with, for obvious reasons occurring in our world, and for the safety of Prince Rush, his parents, and all gathered. Several of our normal customs and protocols have been omitted for this ceremony today. Nevertheless, the most important part, which is the blessing of the Lord and family, unite and love, are present today. For this, we are grateful. Please continue to be reverent and adhere to all safety protocols, including keeping our face mask on during this ceremony, social distancing, and avoid touching with hands. If you should need to use restrooms, please be careful and use disinfectants provided to the best of our ability.
Y'all keeping y'all face mask on?
Amen. Amen.
They told me that I have to learn. Did you leave your phone up there?
Oh, amen.
Yeah. They told me that I have to learn, my doctors and all these good, great people that care so much, and my lovely wife said, you have to learn how to not have to do it all yourself. Let people help you. Let people do it. But when you let people do it, they forget to tell the people about putting on the face mask.
Amen.
And they forget to take out of the notes that we're not wearing face masks no more.
Amen.
However, we should be all right. All right. I think I'm done for the day now, so we're going to move right along. All right. And we're going to modify just a little bit more. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Thank God. As I was sitting there, the Lord began to speak to me and told me to go another direction because we are a different mixture of people here today. And that's a beautiful thing.
Yes, yes.
Amen. So if you don't know by now, I know what I'm doing and I know how to do it. But sometimes you have to twist things around a little bit better, you know, to make it work for everybody. Say everybody.
Everybody.
Amen. And I'm so glad to see Uncle Tommy over there today. And Aunt Jill. Amen. Huh? That's her sister-in-law. Y'all pray for me now. They call themselves keeping you living, but I'm telling you, they do something to your brain with this stuff. And you don't... Praise the Lord. Amen. So we're going to move right along, and we're going to go as the Lord lead us to go. All right? We're just going to do it that way. And that way I don't have to worry about keeping up with this and keeping up with that, because it's all about doing what is important. And before I move forward, I want to thank everybody from Liberty Temple who helped us in such a great way, especially to the mother and grandmother and mother-in-law of Brother Richard, 1 and 2, Sister Renee. She works so hard and vigorously because she doesn't want the normal routine of leadership having to do this, that, and the other. And we're grateful. We just want you to know in front of everybody that we're grateful for what you do. And we're glad about it. And I told Lady Rhonda, I long for the day when some of the others would take on that same mindset so she can sit down and be able to rest and enjoy the fruit of her labor. Going out late at night over to her son and daughter-in-law's house to be there so her daughter-in-law doesn't have to be there alone while her husband's at work. Sometime only getting a little half of a cat nap, and then getting up and going to work and dealing with a whole lot of issues there. God will not forget. God won't forget. And as we say all the time, we pray that God bless you in ways that we never could. Amen. Amen. She needs a car. Amen. Amen. And we're believing God that God will bless her with a car that is reliable, and that she doesn't have to worry about if it's going to start up in the morning, for what she does for others. Thank you. Thank you so much. At this time, we're going to prepare to move forward. You got to hand her over to somebody else now. We thank God for Ellie. Never a dull moment. I watched her here today with them, and I said, good God, I tell you, I wouldn't be able to keep up. But we thank God that God has blessed them at such a young age and a young marriage. You have some people that are married that are still renting apartments, which is okay if that's what you want to do. And that's fine, but the young man worked so hard because he wanted to make sure that within a year's time, year and a half or so, he was able to move his wife into a home of their own. That should be applauded. It really should. It should be applauded. And he allows his wife the freedom to be a homemaker and stay at home and doesn't badger her about making sure bills are paid. You don't have that happen too much anymore. And he doesn't, or at least I don't hear him complain about it. So because of that, the pandemic came in and it slowed us down a little bit. But that just gave him more time to learn more about himself. And we think now that he's ready to take another step up to get where he needs to go. set it in motion. So whether I'm here or not, you'll be on the right path to doing what you need to do for God and His church. If you was to move to Alaska, Australia, anywhere, you would know what God has called you to do. Just do ministry. Hallelujah. Brother Richard, we want you to come and stand. I didn't even pull it up, what's on the back of your little handout. But I believe you'll get it from me. I have it here. Pull it over here. Thank you. Let me borrow that. Thank you so much. We're going to do our very best. And you want to know what you can do besides just enjoying and watching? Pray with us in your heart. That's your assignment. Pray within our heart. Well, I don't know how to pray like you, and I don't know how to pray like you, but I guarantee you if our heart is right, God hears us. Ask God to bless this young man. Ask God to strengthen him. Because he works with all of his might not to show the pressure that is sometime pressing him. And I'll be at home in my bed or wherever, and the Lord will drop him into my heart. But he's trying, and he's doing it, making sure that he is found worthy. 1 Timothy, is where we are? 1 Timothy what?
1 Timothy chapter 3.
1 Timothy chapter 3.
Verse 8.
Start at verse 1, please.
Verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
This is a true saying. Mm-hmm. If a man desire the office of a bishop, he desireth a good work. A bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach, not given to wine, no striker, not greedy of filthy lucre, but patient, not a brawler, not covetous, one that ruleth well his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of God?
Now look at this. This is the bishop. That's what it says to me. Now read on. It's going to say something to you.
Verse 6. Not a novice, lest being lifted up with pride, he fall into the condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. Likewise, must the deacon be grave, not double-tongued, not given to much wine, not greedy of filthy lucre, holding the mystery of the faith in a pure conscience, and let these also first be proved, then let them use the office of a deacon, being found blameless. Even so must their wives be grave, not slanderers, sober, faithful in all things. Let the deacons be the husbands of one wife, ruling their children and their own houses well. For they that have used the office of a deacon well purchase to themselves a good degree and great boldness in the faith which is in Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord. Let him be proven. Proven means to apply pressure, to make sure that something, person, place, or thing is in the position to withstand weight, force, able to take a beating, able to handle things that most people aren't able to endure. Let him be proven. All reformations, churches, and fellowships do things in different ways. Here, Rhea, you're not doing a good job. We realize the weight of becoming a deacon, becoming a bishop. Many people covet those gifts and those positions, but they don't want to meet those requirements that we just heard. The part in there we're lifting up is where it says, let him be proven. Here in this fellowship, as of right now, they are designated. They are hand-picked and hand-selected by leadership to start preparing their heart and their mind and their will to do what needs to be done. And after they are designated, they reach the point of where we are right now, which is called a step up. It's not ordination to the deaconate, but it's officially walking into a time of being tested and tried to make sure you'll be able to meet the qualification. A time for you to stand before God, to step up and say, not am I just going to try to meet the qualifications of where I'm going to, but I'm going to try my best to walk worthy of what I am being called to do. In this fellowship, it's called a walking deacon. A walking deacon is a person who takes on more responsibility. The person that tells the leadership, you stay still, and I'll take the journey. Whatever needs to be done, I'll do it, and I'll do it with a heart that is pure. It won't be a chore for me, but it'll be something that I'm willing to do because I'm willing to be proven. Apply the pressure. So when I really get to where I'm going, I'll be able. Y'all think he's doing something out there on the beat with a gun on his hip and dealing with all those people you deal with out there. But brother, let me tell you, that's a cakewalk compared to dealing with God's people. And you'll understand it better by and by. Walking deacon is one who puts one foot in front of the other, asking God to lead the way, not just with the church and church responsibilities, but with his own family. So, Sister Jennifer, sometime that means God is going to order his steps in a way that you may not be comfortable with, may not like it. That's when you hit your knees and go before God and trust God in him to carry you on the journey. And not just to Jennifer, but for every married woman that is here. One of the worst things you can do to a man is challenge his trust and ability to take care of you and his family. It's like taking a knife and sticking it in and twisting it and turning it. Because women have a way of saying, I want you to feel what I'm saying. But do you realize why you're making them feel what you're saying? You're causing internal injury that you don't have the power to fix. So I encourage you, Jennifer, and every woman that is here, no matter how long you've been married, if he's dropping the ball, hit your knees and talk to God. He won't listen to me. I tried to tell him in all kinds of ways. He just don't listen. He's hard-headed. But I know a God that'll make him listen if you go talk to God. God has a way of making a man hit his knees better than you do. So I encourage you today, Sister Jennifer, just give it to God. And I'm going to leave the rest of that right there. Bible says you got to rule your own house well. You know where we are with that. We've already talked about it. You got it. Still a lot of work to do in that area. Because as men, sometimes it's easier just to give in than to argue and go back and forth. But let me tell you something. Sometimes you're going to give in to something that's going to hurt your family in the long run. And that same woman that convinced you to give in is now going to come back to you and say, how you going to fix this? That's why preachers get on my nerves. They always in somebody's business. Oh, God bless you. I'm just trying to help you. And you that want to be married, and you want to marry a mighty man of God who is powerful and anointed, are you willing to submit? Are you willing? But brother, if you forget to take out the trash and you forget to pay a bill, she ain't gonna submit. I tell you now, they not doing it. Because if you can't take care of the small things, the big things is something that will cause them to worry. So what we're going to do today, we're moving off, and we believe in God for you. As I told you right there a few years back, God's not looking for perfection. We can live for God better if we realize that we have to work towards it. And God knows as long as we're in human flesh, we're going to have to keep working at it. Keep working at it. We expect ourselves to be perfect. But when you wake up and realize you're not perfect and you're not going to be perfect until you leave this earth and go with God, you'll keep working at it. Ask God to show you every day. Lord, show me me. I pray that all the time, and sometimes I don't like what I see. But I ask God to help me to fix it. Father God, help us. If you will, I want our bishop to come. And we're just going to pray over you, that's all. We had a whole lot of other stuff we was going to do, but look, you know what's up. Lord, I'm available to you. And I'll do what you say to do. I love the way his mother loves him. And what we're going to do today, you got your pocketbook? I want you to bring me your oil. And we're going to anoint him and pray for him with your oil. Because if I don't know nothing else, I know you like to talk. But you don't waste no time talking to God either. So I want you to give that oil you had to the bishop. Bishop Alonzo, would you come just for a moment, if you will? You need a chair, they can give it to you. Come on over. You all right?
Yes.
Come on over here. You got it? And you move back a little bit, and then Bishop's going to come over to you, and they're going to pray for you today. Why these two young men? Because they've been married quite some time. and they know what it takes to make it. And I believe in my heart one of the greatest issues in the life of deacons and ministers is their home life. That can make or break them. But I believe the anointing that God has put on these men to be men that are faithful, who have children who are faithful to God, who've done their best. We're believing that God is going to allow that anointing upon them to rest on you. All right? And just believe God every step of the way that you can do it. You can do it. I just don't want to mess up. I just don't want to fail. If you tell God to lead you and guide you, He'll handle the rest of that. Leave that up to God. And let me let you in on a secret. You will mess up. You will fail. But don't ever stay there. Get up and keep moving to do the work of the Lord. I need you all to do something with it. Will you stand with me? And let us pray. I would like to do this. All married ministers, where are they? Would you come, Elder, come over, stand right there. And Elder Tucker and Elder, come on, y'all know what's up. Yes. Uh-huh, Bishop Collins. All the married ministers, if y'all would please come. And we're gonna do this, do it both at one time. All right, First Lady, would you come with Lady Rhonda? And pray for Sister Jennifer. We're going to do it all at one time. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on around there, baby.
Go around there.
Go around. Come right through there. Watch your step. Oh, bless the Lord. Yeah, y'all can come on over. Just come on over. I don't mind. I'm going to move on back some. I'm going to pray with you all from here. Now remember, this is not ordination. This is just the next step up. And if it be the Lord's will, the next step after this will be full ordination. Hallelujah. Go ahead, Bishop. You can pray as the Lord leads you.
Oh, God, and the leaders of the church, oh, God, we pray, oh, God. Oh, God, even the words, oh, God, that come in his mouth, oh, God, and the meditations of his heart will be acceptable unto your son. Oh, God, that you get the glory and honor, oh, God, out of his life. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, that other men might see, oh, God. Oh, God, that there is a man, oh, God, that loves the Lord, that there's a man that serves you, oh, God, that's willing to say yes. Oh, God, that's willing to be an example, oh, God. Oh, God, again, we thank you for the leaders, oh, God, of this. Oh, God, that are committed and committing unto faithful men. Oh, God, the work, oh, God, that needs to be done. Now, we pray your strength, oh, God, and your glory and your blessing upon them. and your anointing upon them this day and forevermore, in Jesus' name. Amen. We give your name the glory. We give your name the honor. You are worthy, oh God. Oh God, you are worthy, oh God. We thank you for this occasion. Oh God, it is a blessed occasion. It is a happy occasion. Oh God, and we praise your name, oh God. We give your name glory. We give your name honor, oh God. For you alone are worthy to be praised, oh God. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, your name is worthy to be praised. We thank you for sparing his life. Hallelujah, oh God, for giving them opportunity to say yes. An opportunity to serve you. Oh God, an opportunity, oh God, to be a man of honor. Oh God, in his home. Hallelujah, in the community. Hallelujah, and in your temple, oh God. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
question. Are y'all Jewish or what? No, we're not Jewish. We're Hebrews. Amen. Search it out. Google it. There's a difference. Hallelujah. And there are certain customs that we follow that others have taken from us and used. But God has given us the desire and the heart to take some things back.
Amen.
And put them back in their rightful place. What are those things? I don't think it's on. It's called... You can be seated if you need to. Thank you. It's called a naming. Come on, baby. Come sit right there. Next. Thank you, Jesus. He was always dancing. I had to wait a minute. It's called a naming. Month of December, 2022. Laying on my bed, I asked God again which way I should go at this time. And God gave me the Hebrew name for this child. Told me why, what it meant. The Lord told me to give him or bestow upon him the name Josiah. Josiah. The king and prince of Judah. A name that means one that wants to bring love and unification to the nation. I encourage you to study the life and the name Josiah. God has heard and God has healed and God has delivered. Thus means the name Josiah. So we bestow upon him today the name that did not come from J.D. Martineau, but from God. For the first male child of this family and the first male child born to a married couple in this establishment. Josiah Israel, spelled with a Y, understanding and knowing that the letter J was not in the Hebrew language or alphabet. Israel, meaning one thing, part of the nation of God's chosen, called out people. Given this day, 15th of Iyar, Hebrew year 5783. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Yahshua, the Messiah, I present to you, let us stand, this young man. Richard Robert.
Yes.
John.
Yes.
Frame.
Yes.
The second. Yes. Let's give God praise for him. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we ask that you would look upon this family.
Yes, sir.
Strengthen them, bless them, cover them in your holy name.
Yes.
Lord, you know what we ask for, and we believe you for it right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God bless you. I told y'all we'll be modified. All right? There you go. And that's it. Is it over yet? Almost. Almost. We're not going to change his shoes and do all that stuff today. But what I am going to do is I'm going to give him his tassel. Because the Bible teaches us that Hebrews wear fringes. They wear fringes because of one reason. It is to remind them of the commandments of God and the responsibility to obey the commandments of God. These are also found on the tallit. But also, you can open it up, thank you. They remind us of movement in the earth. This is why also it has been taken by those who practice yoga and the whatever that religion is. Because when you wear tassels and they are upon your body, they move and they clear things in the earth realm. That's why many tassels look like a broom, because they sweep things away as you move. So I encourage you to find a tassel from somewhere. Put it in your pocket, leave it in your Bible, wherever. Have it consecrated, and when things begin to happen around you, just get it and begin to believe God and just sweep things away. Some things are not found in the scripture, but they're found in the realm of the prophetic. So as you know and understand, you'll be able to do that. And I'm going to give this to you for him, and we'll tell you later on what to do with it. It's already been consecrated. I'm going to give you that. Hallelujah. We'll do the rest of it later, all right? Amen. God bless you. You may have your seat. Thank you all so much today. Go get Barbara.
Okay.
Amen. That have come and shared with us today. As he grows in God and you see things, good things happening in their lives, you will be able to say, I remember when it all got started. And that's a blessing. Hallelujah. The one that said, I come out the church of God in Christ. And I'm not used to going around doing all this fellowship in here. And I need to be stable in one place. Bible study, church, school, morning service. Then if you want to go somewhere else, we can go there then. But we need our own spot. And every time I feel some type of way, I said, you did this. She said, uh-huh. And I told her, I said, well, we're going to give you 5 years. Remember that? Mm-hmm. We're going to give you 5 years. We're going to see how it works. If it don't work in 5 years, I'm going back on the field. I'm telling you now. I'm going back on the field because you can, okay. Praise God. Missionary Barbara told us 2 blocks over where we got married on Lamokin Street. Late pastor, turn it back around. Thank you. Late pastor that was there by the name of Pastor Edna Graves. Coming down the steps, I believe it was in a yellow, butter yellow dress. She turned to Lady Rhonda and she said, what she said?
Wherever you go, I'll go.
And she made that commitment that day. So once she heard that, she really was ready to start a church and get moving. Sister Barbara was with us there before we even started on the steps of True Way, Church of Christ. And I said this year, today, I made up my mind that we're going to do something that the Lord has put on my heart to do. And we believe in doing things with proper order, openly, in the public. When they bring in a president, before you hear somebody call them president-elect, you at least meet them, right? You hear about it. You hear that they've won and they have been placed into that position. So what we're going to do today, Missionary Barbara, Senior Missionary Barbara Tola, Lady Martineau and I have been waiting. We was going to do it before, but we weren't. And what we're going to do today is we are going, by the leading of the Lord, to place you into designate status as a senior evangelist. God bless you. And we thank God for you. You're there in the hospital, but we're here right now. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your loyalty. Thank you for your giving. Not one time in 20 years has a month or a week went by and she has not tithed and gave. And we thank God. God will reward faithfulness. That's right. I was waiting for the tears. Thank you so much. Now, you got to answer this. Are you willing to do what God has called you to do, or should I say continue to do, in the area and in the work and in the office of an evangelist?
Yes, and the Lord be my help.
Praise God. Let's give God praise for her. God bless you, Missionary Tola. We love you. She's moving slow nowadays, but she's moving. Hallelujah. And God is blessing her. Keep being faithful, and God will reward you too. You may be on a job and it seems like you're not being recognized. Do it as unto the Lord. Just do it as unto the Lord, and you will be blessed. Bishop, do you want to have something to say?
Amen. Thank God. It's been a wonderful day.
Amen. Amen. We love you too. God bless you. Senior Bishop, do you want to have something to say?
Glad to be here.
He's glad to be here.
The man never died, but
he's
still alive.
Praise God. Y'all catch that later. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Let us stand. God bless you to all the bishops, Bishop Collins, and to all of the ministers of the gospel. We acknowledge you again and thank God for you. All of our friends and family who have come here and sat for over 2 hours with us. God bless you. And heaven smile upon you. They have some food for you in the back if you want it. All right. Feel free to stay and share with us. We'll send you something, Barbara. All right. We'll send you something over there. Praise the Lord. Amen. We need you to hurry up and get it together so we can get ready to go somewhere, do something. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes. I'm not going to finish it out, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask the deacon designate you know what you are now. Walking deacon. Praise God. See, this is why I don't get up and preach on cameras no more. Praise the Lord. You know what you are. Come on and do the benediction. And if you all know it, I'm going to deal with you later. Praise God. God bless you. Bring your baby with you. You got it? All right. Is this on? Take this.
Baby and pacifier. Thank you all.
Yeah, say all your thank yous.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Yeah. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you, everyone, for coming. Because it means the world. I did not expect everyone here, and it means the world. I love you all. Thank you. Thank you. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent one from another. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
God bless you all.